Miami to start just across their own 5-yard line. First possession of the game. A little zone read, and Rozier hands it off to Travis Homer, and he gets about 4 yards out to the 10-yard line. So Malik Rozier, 11-0 as a starter. Started once for an injured Brad Kaya back in 2015, and he's 10-0 this season.
You know, he reminds me of Trace McSorley from Penn State a year ago, and you saw what he did all the way, taking the Nittany Lions all the way to the Rose Bowl. Just a winner. He just has that it factor. It doesn't matter what it takes. It's not always going to be the most fundamental and the prettiest, but he has just got a tremendous amount of resolve, and his offense feeds off of it.
Right about at the first down marker, driven back is Christopher Herndon, a yard shy, and it brings up a third down. Jordan Whitehead, who might be the best player on this Pitt defense, stepped up to make the stop.
In a third down area where Miami has really struggled this season, surprisingly so, with some of the strength that they've got, the power of Homer, the run pass options, but oftentimes not near enough push at the point of attack with the offensive line.
They'll try and run for it with Homer. And it looks like he's got it by about a half a yard.
It was a good thing it was only a yard to gain. If that was 2 or 3, he doesn't get home. And you see some of the challenges right there. Casey McDermott, the left tackle, is thrown out of the way. Homer's pad level and that continued effort moves the chains. But this is what Pitt wants to do. Pitt's going to give a little bit. They're going to bend a little bit in the early downs. And they want to get into some of those third down situations and see if Miami can be better in that down and distance than they've been this season.
Rozier to throw. On the slant, bobbled. And a chance at an interception for Phil Campbell as Amon Richards had it go through his hands. Campbell was lurking, and that ball almost bounced right to him.
And there's a lot of congestion to that short side of the field. Look at it. There's multiple Pitt defenders to the field, and I think that's going to be the reminder today. To the field was a wide-open Braxton Berrios. You're thrown into some trouble. Phil Campbell making his first start as a redshirt freshman. An opportunity to make a big play for Pitt. They're going to need those takeaways. But trust me, over the course of this game, that throw is going to go the other way to Berrios, to the wide side of the field.
5 wide on 2nd down and 10. 4-man rush. Rozier under pressure. Down he goes at the 10-yard line. Dwayne Hendricks, his 3rd sack of the season.
This is a really nice thing. You're going to see Miami employ this same amount of defense and effort with their group up front. This is just a beautifully timed tackle and stunt here from Pitt. And this is not something they've been very good at this year. In fact, that's just Hendricks' 3rd sack of the season. 7.5 is an entire defensive line, but you can't run it more effectively and efficiently than they just did.
3rd down and long. And it looks like Pitt may bring pressure. Long throw up the seam, just off the fingertips of Jeff Thomas. That was a nice throw from Malik Rozier, but it turns into a Miami punt from deep in their own end.
Yeah, that throw just led him away, Bob. If that throw is to his inside, again, this is going to be a little bit of a feel for Rozier. It's an awfully big moment for him as well, out on the road. I think a couple decisions there. If thrown into a tight window, that time you've got to lead your receiver to the entire field, and Thomas is going to keep running.
Quadri Henderson, one of the most lethal return men in the history of the ACC. Will he get a chance here? Calling for a fair catch in plus territory. Great field position for Pitt when we come back after only a 35-yard punt by Zach Fegels.
Neil Lane designs for Hollywood's biggest stars, and at Kay, he designs for the star in your life.
This ring was inspired by an Art Deco design that goes back 100 years.
At Kay, the number one jewelry store for...
Yes! Every kiss begins
with Kay. All you smart holiday shoppers will be glad to know Buick has great deals planned for you this Black Friday. Or if you prefer, Crimson Red Tint Coat Friday. Or Quicksilver Metallic Friday.
Ring in the holidays with Buick. It's the Enclave Black Friday event at your Buick dealer. Get 20% below MSRP on all 2017 Enclave premium models. That's over 10,500 on this specially equipped Enclave.
keeping a friendship alive for 200 years requires mutual respect. Genuine affection. And the right beer.